Mercedes was pursued by Johnny.
Yes. From the beginning.
From the beginning.
I think he's just honestly in it for the game and he's super fake. And I will be expecting him in my DM. So y'all will know that.
Can I put my leg here? Can you just like touch a little?
Oh man, you're killing me. The whole time I was there, I thought about you.
I'm literally so happy.
Well, how are you guys feeling? Not a lot of shakeups this season with the Casa Amor. How are we feeling?
You know, the boys were just... I mean, I feel like they were too scared to really make moves.
They were tough.
They were, yeah, it was like walking into maybe some walls. But it was definitely tough just trying to get in there and shake things up. I mean, you could tell some of the boys wanted to, but it was hard. It was really hard.
I think a lot of them just wanted to play it safe.
Play it safe for sure.
Yeah. It definitely became clear when we walked in there. I think the girls had some discussion about how here we were for love. Mm-hmm. And when we left, we were like, we're not 100% sure that the boys aren't here for the game. So,
yeah, it felt just like they were in it for the game and it was more of like a bro time.
Yeah.
It was constantly like, hey, we're here. Hey, we're here.
What is like your strategy going into this? Because the Casa Amor is so tough because yes, you have to get, you want to get somebody's attention. You want to go for someone that's like kind of on the fence with their couple, but then you don't want to come on too strong. So like, what is your mentality going in there?
Yeah. So we actually have talked a lot about this, especially being together now. And we had a terrible strategy.
Terrible.
We were all like, you know what? Let's let it unfold organically and we'll just talk to everyone and see what
they're at.
And none of us ended up talking to the guy that we initially wanted to talk to. And we just like fell in the trap of a shiny new toy after being in quarantine for too many days to count. So the strategies were just gone with the wind.
They were off 100%. I think that's what we're saying. Like we should have definitely went in there and said, we're doing this, but I mean, quarantine, you know, hit us out of the...
You just go crazy. You can't concentrate on any guy. It's like, okay.
I'm normally a very particular girl, and I feel like quarantine threw me through a loop that literally Calvin batted his eyes at me, and I was a goner. there was no coming back from what had started.
Well, yeah. I mean, I say the same thing. Like, I definitely went on there trying to ride the C train, and I don't know where that kind of went.
off the rails.
Off the rails. That's where that went. But yeah, it was definitely tough with the time frame. It was hard, but I'm glad that I met you girls.
I know.
I feel like everything just happened the way it was supposed to, but
for sure.
Mercedes, you made some bold plays. You made some waves in Casa Amor. I mean, you were at the forefront of my screen. So you saw what you wanted with Johnny and you went for it.
Well, I just actually like, you know, you were saying the whole quarantine thing. Johnny is not my typical type. It was just not in the image for me. And I don't know if I went in and then he just came in hot and I didn't know how to handle it. So I was like, I kind of like this. I haven't been around a boy in a while. And then after I was like, what happened? Not my type, first of all. Like, what even happened? But yeah. And then it's just... Yeah, I'm just like, I'm still even lost. I can't even like say anything.
I'm so curious because the way it played out on screen was like, he was like, no, I'm with Sally, I'm not break. But I was like, Mercedes wouldn't be going for him so hard if there wasn't something there.
I felt like it was almost like I walked in and I was claimed.
There was a competition that we did when we were competing against the villa. And we had, I think it was the last thing in the competition, we had to kiss passionately with one other person. So the strategy was do it as quickly as you can. Mm-hmm. So Johnny and I kiss.
I kissed Calvin.
You kissed Calvin. Everybody kissed the person next to them.
Yep.
Johnny like threw me back down, makes eyes at Mercedes, and we all just like sink into our chairs and watch him charge across the couch area and take Mercedes into the most passionate kiss. Mercedes was pursued by Johnny.
Yes.
From the beginning.
From the beginning. I feel like I was just like, okay, like I didn't even know how to take it. That's how strong he was coming on. So I was like, I had to tell him like, you better be up in front with Sally. Like she needs to know, you know, and there was a couple times where I'm like, I don't even know how to handle how strong he's coming on. Even the girls felt like they couldn't even talk to him because how strong he was coming on to me. And like I said, when I walked in, that was not even a focus. And then when I tried to take my focus off of him and go to Carrington, he like was making little remarks like, well, have fun on your date, or like, really? If you feel like you need to do that. Yeah, if you need, if you feel like you need to do that to get to know him, go for it. And I was just like, okay, someone's jealous, but you're telling me that you want Selly, and then in bed it's very different. And I'm like, I'm just so confused by you. So I think he's just honestly in it for the game, and he's super fake. And I will be expecting him in my DM. So y'all will know that.
Oh my God. This is adding up, because his ex has been posting TikToks about him and how he's like really possessive and all this kind of stuff.
Ooh. Oh, I felt that. 100%. Even the girls were like, dude, you and Johnny? And I was like, me and Johnny, like, definitely. Like, you guys can like speak for me too, as no, well. Yeah.
No. I mean, he had his eyes on her from the beginning, and he was not going to let her go. I mean, he was definitely just playing the game. He like wanted, what is it, want his cake and eat it too, or whatever. It's yep. like, he wanted to have all of Mercedes, but then have the image of, oh no, but like, I'm super into Selly.
Yeah. So. And I even told him, I was like, I'm not just gonna be some fun for you at Casa Amor. And that's when my like direction went from Johnny to Carrington, and he was pissed about it. He was so pissed.
Yeah.
100%. I feel like he even told Carrington, like, no, you're not allowed, you know? Yeah.
So do you think his feelings for Selly aren't genuine?
No. Mm-hmm. I feel like it's maybe there, but like, I don't know. If he was so quick to like...
You have to remember the environment that you're into.
True.
Because sometimes it's not so much, are the feelings the strongest, or are they strongest out of the collection of girls that are there? Mm-hmm. And that's like a really important mentality to keep when you're thinking Love Island, because I mean, you have limited options and you're just trying to figure out what's the best fit based on the options that I have. And I think he was confused because he might have had loyalty to Selly because they've been in this since the beginning. But it was very obvious how quickly his head could turn when Mercedes walked through the door.
Did you guys get to watch tonight's episode? Did you?
No. No. We haven't seen anything yet, but I know it's going to go down.
I'm so curious because, yeah, when Johnny was telling Selly basically that he had made out with you and like cuddled with you, and then, but I just felt like he was like putting it on you and being like, well, Mercedes was coming on to me and
oh, God.
I let her kiss me and she wanted to kiss me.
Oh my God.
I expected nothing less from him. And I knew he would sugarcoat it.
Yeah, and that's what I was expecting too. I was like, I have a really big feeling he's not going to say what he actually did. But I mean, the girls were there.
We know.
Ask them. They know.
We
know.
We told her, we'll defend her till the day that we die, because we saw it go down and we all were a little apprehensive that his approach wouldn't be genuine.
Yeah, and even after when he was saying bye, like, I felt like he was just a little too close for comfort by my lips. Like, I was like, okay, that hug did not need to be like that if you were going back home to Selly.
Yep.
Just saying. Like, you could have said bye and we would have been fine.
I'm so fascinated by this. Okay, so then you shifted over to Carrington, much to Johnny's dismay. And he, I thought he was going to pick you, because he picked you on the date and he kind of seemed like he was into you on that last day, and then he actually went with Laurel. So did you expect him to go with Laurel, or like, when did you?
I felt like I was led on. The way I seen Laurel and him interact, I was like, oh, okay, like, whatever. And then even when he picked me for the date, I was like, really? Like, me? Really? Mm-hmm. But I mean, I like to live in the moment and just kind of give it my all and put myself out there. And I feel like that's what I did. I was true to myself and I was trying to see where it was going. It sounded great what he was saying. So I was like, oh, like, really? Like, but I guess I just didn't see that coming. But I feel like it's a big thing on Johnny's part. I didn't see he was going to let that happen. Just because of the comments he was saying when I was hanging around with Carrington, you could just tell he was either jealous that it wasn't him or he didn't want me to go back to the villa. Mm-hmm. So I feel, and Carrington also mentioned like he, you know, him and Johnny are really close and he cares about how Johnny thinks about things. And I know for sure Johnny was probably influencing him negatively on his choice of who he was taking back to the villa.
Faith, I was also surprised. I thought that, like, I didn't really see Calvin and Cher interacting that much. And I
know. You both.
Yeah.
I was really surprised at that. I thought you guys had a thing. You guys were, like, making out at the pool party at one point. I was like, oh, okay, they're together.
You know, I thought the same. Like, I went into Casa and I really only had eyes for Calvin. I was so excited to meet him. And I really felt like we would have a strong connection. And we did, honestly, like when we were talking, I don't know if he'd say the same, clearly that's not the case, seeing as that I sit back at the Rio. But yeah, we had a good thing going, great conversation, we were having a lot of fun. And ultimately we were at a cocktail party, I think it was night three, and we all cheersed our glasses and Calvin led the toast and he was like, you know, cheers to Love Island, where one conversation can change everything, and quite literally made eyes at Sher and said, can I steal you for a chat, Sher? And I was like,
what?
All of us were like, what?
Like, oh, okay.
Oh, okay. I guess that was one-sided. And he honestly, he never talked to me about it. He kind of just like ghosted me in person. And I had to pull teeth to get him to give me a straightforward answer on what went wrong, when did he decide that he wasn't interested in me anymore. But yeah, it was honestly pretty surprising. I thought that we were in a good spot, so.
These men, oh my God.
Girl. No, don't be fooled. You just
boys,
be
sorry.
Men. Yeah, we love some these boys,
much like that.
Yeah, that's more clear.
GiNiele, who did you connect with most? I saw, because you were talking to Caleb at one point, but he seemed pretty like, I am going back to Justine.
Yes, going into it, I did have my eyes on Caleb and Connor, but Caleb was very adamant about the fact that he was going back to Justine. He was just like, he told me like on day two, that's what his decision was going to be. So I was like, okay. With Connor, I already knew I was not going to get anywhere with Connor. I think America knew that with Connor, there was just no absolute way. Mm-hmm. So throughout my time in Casa Amor, honestly, Connor and I did connect. Like, we would talk on the regular. He opened up to me. I was giving him, like, advice about Mackenzie. Like, we just kind of developed this whole friendship where he was just like, I'm glad you're here for me, you know? Like, that's kind of, like, where it went inside during my time at Casa Amor. So, I mean, hey, the two people that I were into just were adamant about staying single.
With their girls.
Yeah.
Well, and just to be clear, like, Connor is a precious gem of a man.
Oh, yeah.
Like, we love him. He is a good human. We want nothing but good things for him. Correct. But he is in a sticky situation.
Yep. I was going to say, did you guys know that Mackenzie recoupled?
I knew it.
We knew this.
My God. But it's his fault.
It is his fault.
You can't even be like, feel bad for him.
And every single one of us girls said before we went in, if Connor would make himself open to it, he was the only boy that all of us.
Connor is so hot. He's so sweet.
So sweet.
He's just like the most genuine like guy there.
Yeah.
So if he would have just been open to like making connections, oh my God.
Yeah, he was just open, honestly, as a person though.
As a friend.
Which I do admit and appreciate, just because like none of the boys were.
They
were like, bro.
And this is bro time.
I was like, okay, there is girls here. No. Like, are you?
We were on a bachelor trip.
Yes, we were on a bachelor trip.
And Johnny was like the one calling the shots for me. I was like, okay, I'm just here. So.
Connor walked out holding Mackenzie's teddy bear. I was like.
Shut up.
Oh my.
Is he okay?
I mean, I don't know. It was so hard to watch.
Like, no.
She couldn't even look at him. She was like, oh my God. Like,
oh my God.
That's on him, though. That's all
I have to say. I mean, he's not perfect in this situation. He did some stuff there too, but my gosh.
I just want to hug him.
Oh, that breaks my heart.
It's his fault.
No, yeah, definitely.
I mean,
I had a conversation with him and he said he would come after me and I was like, well, you're my type, so I'm waiting on you, honey.
I know, there's a straight up DM match that's going to go down for all of us with Connor as soon as he's
I was like, whose DMs are we going into now?
Oh gosh.
They come into my DMs, okay?
There you go.
Coming over here, but
no,
I'm
not too proud to say, catch me in Connor's DMs.
Me too. Can I take him for a chat?
Yeah,
for a
chat.
Can we
have a
lumber snack?
Just real quick.
I know.
So is now that it's all said and done, is there anything you would change about your experience on Love Island if you could go back?
What
would you do differently?
Yeah. Go first.
Oh, girl. I would shut Johnny down, be like, no, I would have embarrassed him in so many ways and just been like, you need, like, How do I even say this? Like, I feel like I was just like claimed and like had no real say so. Yeah, I would definitely go in there with a better mind on who I'm going for and my interests rather than just being like, okay, where does the wind take me? You know, right. Just definitely, it was like Johnny. And that was just, I was a little like upset on that because that was just not what I went in for.
I agree. And like even watching the book, because we get to watch the show before we go in. So we kind of have a sense of what's going on in the villa before we meet anyone. And I wish that I wouldn't have let my preconceived notions dictate my actions once I went in, because like Carrington, for instance, I wrote him all the, any boy that is a self-proclaimed alpha is straight up on my don't touch list. And then I got in there and like Carrington
he was so sweet.
He was so sweet. And I wish that I would have given him a shot because I was genuinely the most surprised by him.
That's why I'm like, what are you doing, boy? Because I mean, I feel like everything we talked about, it was like such a great connection. But
yeah,
I feel
he's a good guy.
I feel like it was Johnny. Like Johnny just was like, Mercedes is mine. Like no one could touch. Like my fun. And it like, I do just like, I would have been like swerve. But
yeah,
I don't really regret anything that happened with me and Casa Amor. I just wish Jeremiah and or Trey were there and it would have been a different story.
Jeremiah, I loved him.
Jeremiah. I know. Girl, me too. Trust. I was so sad when he left.
He was a precious angel.
Now I'm sad that I'm not there for Connor. I'm like,
I know.
I would have been like, Connor, we have mine.
We've got some shoulders for you to
cry
on. Right, a bosom to cry on.
Bring them.
A bosom.